Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 15 of our GoLang course. In this lesson, we are going to cover arrays, a widely used composite data type in programming. So let's begin. Arrays are fundamental data structures that serve as containers for storing data in a specific order. They store data in contiguous blocks of computer memory, allowing for efficient access and manipulation of data. Within an array, each individual piece of data is called an element. These elements are organized in a linear fashion, forming the overall content of an array. In Go programming language, adherence to strong typing means that all elements contained inside the array must share the same data type. This ensures data integrity and consistency when working with arrays. Go provides the flexibility in creating arrays, allowing you to use any data type for the elements, as long as all of the elements in the arrays are of same type. Retrieving a specific piece of data from an array involves specifying its position, known as index. The index serves as a unique identifier for each element within the array. In array indexing, Go employs a zero-based system, which is very common with most of the programming languages. This means that the first element of an array is accessed using an index of 0. The second element would have an index of 1, and so forth. So basically what we are trying to say is, the start of array starts from a zero index. This indexing convention is a core principle in array manipulation and traversal. Let's look at an example of how array sits in the memory of a computer. Here we have an array comprising of 5 elements, giving it a length of 5. It's important to note that array indexing begins at 0 and ends at length minus 1, so the last element will have an index of length of the array minus 1. As you can see, the length of the array is 5 here because we have 5 elements, so the last element index is 5 minus 1 equal to 4. Observing the array closely, we find that the integer values are assigned to specific indices. 10 resides at index 0, 30 at index 1, 5 at index 2, 50 and 9 at index 3 and 4, respectively. It's worth highlighting the fact that arrays cannot process a length or index lower than 0, so you cannot have an index lower than 0. Attempting to access an element at index below 0 or beyond the final index, which is again length minus 1, will lead to panic in Go code, causing the program to terminate unexpectedly if the panic is not handled. We will talk about panics when we go into the Go error handling. I'm talking about this because this is a common problem often encountered by newcomers to array-based programming. Let's look at some benefits of array. Array excel in their efficiency for both storing and retrieving elements from memory. The program processes the array's initial memory address, facilitating seamless calculation of the precise memory address for any given index. The calculation is achieved by multiplying the data type's memory size by index and then adding this product to the initial address. Arrays are very useful in storing a list of data. It is very common to see arrays of numbers, names, and various other data types. Arrays are widely used in the realm of search and sorting algorithms, underpinning the essential processes. Furthermore, arrays find practical applications in memory buffers, where data is processed in batches using buffers. Now, let's look at different ways of declaring an array in Go. First up, we encounter the most elementary array declaration, an integer array A of size 5 spanning index 0 to index 4. The array's elements assume a default 0 value aligning with the int data type, which is 0. The next array declaration incorporates specific values assigned to distinct indices. Here, we say that we have an array of size 5 and the array comprises of value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 at indices 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Next up, we have a sparse array. Despite maintaining the size of 5, this array selectively holds values for certain indices. Indices lacking provided value assume the default value for integers, which is 0. Here I am saying is index 0 value is 5, index 2 value is 10, and the last index value is 50. Rest of them should be of 0 value, which is 0 for integers. Last, we have the ellipsis notation signifying Go's autonomous determination of array size based on the number of initialized element. What that means is, when I declare an array like this, Go will automatically pick up the length of the array or the size of the array from the elements in the array. So here, the length will be 3. If I put 5 elements, the length will be automatically assigned to 5. Just to revise, in the first array declaration, I am saying I have an array A of type int which holds 5 elements and all of the elements are 0. Next, I say I have an array A of type int and length 5 and I have initialized all the elements in the array starting from 1 to 5. Next up, I say I want a sparse array, which means that the array length is still 5, but I want the 0 index value to be 5, second index value to be 10, and last index value to be 50, while rest of them should be 0. The last array declaration we saw is using ellipses, where the length of the array is implicit. That is, it's dependent on how many numbers you add here. The versatile len function provided by Go can be used to get the length or size of the array. Arrays find their niche in scenario where a fixed size is imperative, such as cryptography algorithms. It is crucial to know arrays possess a predetermined unchangeable size. So once declared, the size of array cannot be altered. The size and length of the array are stored in the type of the array. This is specific to Go. So when you declare an array of type int but of size 2, the size itself resides on the type of the array. The size constraint also means that once an array is declared, if you wanted to add more elements than the size allows you, you cannot do that. What you would have to do is create a bigger size array and copy all the elements from the old array to the new array. This also means that you cannot use a variable to specify the length or size of the array as it needs to be a compile time constant value. Despite their efficiency, arrays are relatively uncommon in Go code. Instead, slices, which act as a wrapper around array, takes the center stage. We will be covering slices in depth in the following sessions. Slices address the limitation and also add value to arrays. In the following lesson, we will look at arrays with some Go code. We will also explore how to use the len function to calculate the length of the array and look at different declaration types in Go. Thanks for watching the video. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. I will see you in the next lesson. Happy coding.